Hey, what is up all? Today I'll be farming Heart of the Wall to try to get a piece of goggles that I've been trying to farm for a long time. I've been farming for over 200 hours now and I haven't got it yet. So one of the streamers mentioned that he had a better chance of getting like goggles from one of the maps. So it seems that might be a fixed loot table for the different maps. I don't know, but I'm gonna give it a shot. I've left his link and name in the description below, so do check it out. So let's go.
Julo's people.
More bodies around an obelisk mechanism. Seems they were trying to activate it.
So how many rounds of this map do you think it'll take for me to get that particular goggles?
Thank you.
Outrider. I have the approximate location of a pod for you.
There's the pod, but it looks like the forest has claimed it for itself. Whoa! The whole forest seems to be pissed at me. Where the hell did the pod go? Still gonna be that monster.
you know I found you think I'll get it in the first try?
And the beast responsible for your missing people. The beasts were too quick. Never gave them time to react.
Thank you, Outrider. We can finally put them to rest.
Access granted.
Alright, so I got two legendary weapons. He mentioned that the drop chance for weapons weren't that high, so let's see. I'm gonna try that run again. No idea why everything is highlighted. Like, it's been bugged since the update. But it was the mine muggler and the daimo, right? This is gonna make it difficult for me to figure out which are the new items since everything is being highlighted all the time. Let's give it another shot. Let's see. We have to go to the lobby and come back to reset the choices of maps. Nope, we have to do it again. How many tries do you think I'll need? There we go.
Rider, sometime ago.
Thank you.
More bodies around an obelisk mechanism. Seems they were trying to activate it.
approximate location of a pod for you.
There's the pod, but it looks like the forest has claimed it for itself. Whoa! Whole forest seems to be pissed at me. Where the hell did the pod go?
getting a bit worried there.
Juno, I found the pod. And the beast responsible for your missing people. Beasts were too quick. Never gave them time to react.
Thank you, Outrider. We can finally put them to rest.
Access granted.
Okay, we're gonna go reset the map.
Some time ago, the night sky was lit up by a...
Bodies around an obelisk mechanism. Seems they were trying to activate it. Thank you.
Oh, did it bug up? I think it bugged up. Ah, damn. Gotta redo it. That is annoying. Thank you. That was getting a little too hot.
Outrider, I have the approximate location of a pod for you.
There's the pod, but it looks like the forest has cloned it for itself. Whoa! Whole forest seems to be pissed at me. Where the hell did the pod go?
Get that. But I'm still gonna get that one.
Juno, I found the pod. And the beast responsible for your missing people. Beasts were too quick. Never gave them time to react.
Thank you, Outrider. We can finally put them to rest.
Entrance detected. Access granted.
One legendary. Oh, this is annoying. All of them are marked as new. What an annoying bug. There must be a smarter way of doing this. Let's reset the map. I'm starting to feel that it doesn't work.
Beast. More bodies around an obelisk mechanism. Seems they were trying to activate it.
Let's go. buff.
I have the approximate location of a pod for you.
There's the pod, but it looks like the forest has claimed it for itself. Whoa! The whole forest seems to be pissed at me. Where the hell did the pod go?
Lost the buff.
you know, I found the pod. And the beast responsible for your missing people. Beasts were too quick. Never gave him time to react.
Thank you, Outrider. We can find some adventurers.
Access granted.
Oh, I have to redo this. It's definitely a bug. What? Items that I selected to dismantle got resetted. Oh man, this is beyond annoying. I'm such a hoarder. Holy shit! Again? Does this mean I have to redo everything again? God. Tell me I don't have to reselect everything. Oh man. Oh, what is this bullshit? Yes, I finally made it. Oh God. How long was I stuck doing that shit? Okay, reset the map. Here we go. Here we go.
Rider, some time ago the night sky was lit up by a...
Bodies around an obelisk mechanism. Seems they were trying to activate it.
the approximate location of a pod for you.
There's the pod, but it looks like the forest has claimed it for itself. Whoa! Whole forest seems to be pissed at me. Where the hell did the pod go?
So I actually have a video of myself at, using this build and playing it already in the list of videos I've uploaded, so you can check that out as well, but I'll definitely share with you the build like right after this expedition.
You all look pretty angry, I get that, but I'm still gonna be out of pocket.
No problem. Give me a while, I think it's the last part. I'm gonna go get the crawlers before they overwhelm me. All right.
Juno, I found the pod. And the beast responsible for your missing people. Beasts were too quick. Never gave them time to react.
Thank you, Outrider. We can finally put them to rest.
Outriders are defected. Access granted.
Alright, here's the skill tree. So the most important the class points that I need for my build is the mobility ones. So it's this one, cooldown for movement skills, and this one, right? And a lot of people run with this skill. I sacrifice this for mobility, and by doing so, that allows me to replenish my ammo with just one mod. So with instant reload, I'm able to replenish my magazine before I run out of bullets. If you don't run that, there's a high chance you'll need to run a second mod. Most people will run with ammo's bargain, and that will actually replenish like 20% of your magazine every time you kill a mob. I'm still deciding like which is better, but I think I prefer this playstyle because it allows me to maintain the twisted round buffs whenever I'm fighting like, you know, bosses and elites. Because usually when you're fighting bosses and elites, if there aren't any mobs around, especially when you're playing with three players, you know, some of them may kill the mobs really fast. I don't have a means of getting my ammo back quick enough, so I'll end up waiting for my cooldowns to be up before I can replenish my ammo using instant reload. But by building it this way, I'm not dependent on killing mobs to get my ammo. I'm just dependent on using Hunt the Prey, my teleport. So I find it's a lot smoother, and I'm also more aware of how many rounds I have. I can count 15 rounds every time I fire. I can count how many rounds I fired. Where else, when you're using ammo's bargain, you have to like keep note of like, you know, how many rounds you have left. It's okay too. I think there's some builds out there that can use that, and there's some situations where that might be better. Like, you know, if there are a lot of mobs in one area and you're just firing continuously, you don't have to teleport if you have ammo's bargain. But then again, if you teleport often, you will get you'll kind of refresh the buff that you get from from your class tree, because you have this buff that you get, and you know, every time you use a movement skill, you get 35% weapon damage increase. So you know, if you use it often, like, you know, you're maintaining this buff. It's kind of overkill because my cooldown is like 3.9 seconds at the moment, so you know, I can use my teleports very often, and I find that it's very useful when I'm doing solo, because I can use positioning to kind of keep me alive. If I'm playing in trees, what I might do is I might sacrifice a bit of mobility. So instead of using Dance of Death, I would run another offensive mod to increase my damage even further. And I have a video showing how much damage I can do. I did like 9 million damage in one shot with a automatic shotgun. I'll link it, give me a second. Okay, so I've shared the build. This is more or less the same as what you just saw, just that it doesn't have Dance of Death. It's using another offensive mod, and the video shows you like what you can do with that build, especially in trees, whereby you know doing more damage is probably more useful because the mobs are kind of distracted. You know, there are two other players where the mobs you know can redirect the focus on, so you are free to do more damage. Whereas if you're doing solo, you know I prefer to have like something a bit more defensive, and I think like the Dance of Death, it's kind of a balance between defense and offense, because you know I get to teleport more, so I get to replenish my ammo and I get to be very offensive in my positioning. Where else defensively, every time you use the Hunt the Prey, you get shield, and you can also get out of sticky situations with that. So if you're looking for good solo build, you could definitely use this. If you find it's a bit too difficult, I have another build which is a variation of this. So instead of using Vanita's knife, I'm using Slow Trap, and I used that when I was doing Eye of the Storm at CT15 solo. I haven't uploaded the video, but I could if you think it'll help you. So I found that to be a bit more defensive and a little easier. It might be easier for you if you are a new player, I'm not sure, because this build has very high offense, the one I'm currently using, but I can actually die if I'm not careful. Like if I get like stun locked by something or teleport to a position whereby I'm like totally surrounded, I could die pretty easily, especially if the enemy has a lot of range classes or a lot of classes that can actually knock you down, right? So in those maps where there are humans with rifles, you know, snipers and all that, they're pretty dangerous for me. So I have to like prioritize which targets I have to kill, and when I teleport, I have to teleport to positions whereby I kind of can line of sight some of those mobs so that I don't take too much damage. Basically, you want to kill a lot of mobs in order to get your shield and health back to survive, right? So you be offensive to survive, but you can't just YOLO into a group of mobs. You have to choose where you teleport to. You know, you want to take out key targets, you want to teleport to places where you are, you know, you have line of sight. You know, you can use line of sight to kind of prevent damage from coming from all directions. Do you have any other questions? I'll just browse through the inventory so you can take a look. This video will be available to view later, so you could always pause it if you want. But then again, I've shared a link with you, so you can just refer to that. There might have been some changes in this because I've been like toying around, tweaking the build here and there, but it should be like more or less the same as the link that you see there. Oh yeah, one of the other changes I made was mitigation from death. I'm using the emergency something, the one where you get golem's protection when your health gets low. But recently I've been noticing that skill hasn't been working very well. So mitigation from death seems to be the next best alternative for me, because you get armor whenever you kill enemies using your sights. So you have to make sure that you're always killing a few enemies every 10 seconds, and be very careful. Like, you know, if you haven't been killing any enemies for a while and you're fighting a very strong elite, like, you have to be extra careful with how you push, because you might die because of you know, you're quite squishy, right? That's also how Hunt the Prey comes in useful, because when you teleport, you get shield, and you know, if you're getting low, you can always teleport away to another mob that's further away to kind of like recover and then come back in, right? The cooldown's only 3.9 seconds. If you're running the other build that I shared with you in the link below, the cooldown's about 4.8 seconds around there. So you know, it's still pretty short. It's still enough for you to like maintain your twisted rounds, although sometimes you have to wait for like a split second before you can teleport if you're like spamming all your rounds at one go. I'm going to clear my inventory right now. Do let me know if you have any other questions. I'll be happy to answer you. I'll just clear my inventory really quickly and I'll try farming that map again. Because someone mentioned that, you know, that the drop rate for helmets is a lot higher for that. So far, that hasn't really been the case for me. But, you know, if it works, I can... Maybe I can finally get the goggles I'm looking for. And that's for a build that I want to experiment with. It's an anomaly build. So far, I've been testing like various anomaly builds. I haven't really gotten it to work well. I mean, like, you know, I can do damage with it. It's just that it's nowhere as good as this current build I'm running. Like, nowhere close. So, like, there's no reason for me to use it then, right? Yeah, you do need to farm. If you want, I could. What's your level now? Are you max level yet? I'm trying to get that map again, yeah. Oh yeah, max level, okay, great. Do you want me to carry you?
Most of the time, life on you.
Some time ago, the night sky was lit up by a pod that landed a few miles from our camp.
Bodies around an obelisk mechanism. Seems they were trying to activate it.
Outrider. I have the approximate location of a pod for you.
There's the pod, but it looks like the forest has cloned it for itself. Whoa! Whole forest seems to be pissed at me. Where the hell did the pod go? you know, I found the pod. And the beast responsible for your missing people. Beasts were too quick. Never gave them time to react.
Thank you, Outrider. We can finally put them to rest.
Outriders are detected. Access granted.
Gonna pause for a while. Alright, I'm gonna end the farm here. So just